Hello to everyone. Welcome to the Czech Joy presentation at the Ji.hlava International Documentary Film Festival. I'm very happy I can host this beautiful event. My name is Diana Tabakov. I'm the executive director of the VOD platform dafilms.com. And we have a great program ahead of us for you who are looking for Czech films for your festivals or for your distribution. This is the right place to be. You will see pitches of nine filmmakers who have their premieres in the program of Ji.hlava Festival. We have actually four world premieres out of these nine films. Others are also international premieres or Czech premieres. So each of the filmmakers have only 8 minutes to present their film. So in this time, we will be able to meet at least in person the directors and producers and then watch a small trailer or teaser of the film. So I would like to start. I would love to invite the representatives of the project Alchemical Furnace. I would like to invite the director Adam Oľha, who is also the documentary filmmaker, a cinematographer, and you might remember him from his film New Life of a Family album that was also previously screened at Ji.hlava Film Festival. And the film was directed also by Jan Daňhel, who was the editor of Jan Švankmajer's film Insects, for example. The other presenter will be also Zuzana Mistríková, the producer of this film. So Adam and Zuzana, could you please tell us more about your film?
Hello, everybody. Thank you for watching us online. We would like to present our film Alchemical Furnace, which is like a little time-lapse documentary about Jan Švankmajer and his workshop. Workshop means that he's alongside with Jaromír Kalista creating the movies of his kind, like long metrage movies since 1980s, where they were kind of first private alternative and whatever distribution in Czechoslovakia
production
company, and they asked us to create a documentary about them. The story is very simple. Like after the last movie of Jan Švankmajer, Insect, which we were part of, like I was doing the documentary part and another director, Honza Daňhel, was doing the editing. We were following all the process of the movie and we thought that it might be the beginning of the new documentary. Fortunately, the film is not just about making insect, but it's a film about what was happening after and a little bit by balancing what they were doing all decades together. And I would say that this film is not like the classical portrait, but it's so-called parasite movie, as we called it with Jan Daňhel, which use like parasite ideas of his work, but we didn't want to copy or imitate the work of Jan Švankmajer. So the important thing is that we were like kind of trying to get into process and revealing this process in the film that should say to audience that we are not going to make a portrait, but rather it's not necessary to make a artifact, but we are going to make a film about process of thinking, process of also of work. And it's very important that he went a little bit deeper than we supposed. So this film offers you to see complex personality of him, of Jaromír Kalista, and also Eva Švankmajerová, who is still present in the film, beside the fact that she died more than 11 years ago?
I just say that we were very privileged to do this film. It was big journey and big joy, I have to say. I think we had the possibility to do this film because Jan Švankmajer and Jaromír Kalista just trusted Jan Daňhel and Adam Oľha, and then just let him really enjoy their world, their private lives, their thinking, their work, everything. And I think it's very nice to know that the name of the film, it's translation of the name of this production company Adam mentioned, because Atanor means alchemical furnace. So I hope that the film will be for everyone who love or like Jan Švankmajer and the world of surrealism and imagination, like very joyful, and they will really enjoy.
If I can add something, I would like to say that we are very pleased that they allowed us to make film without any complaints about any distractions, and they just let us go. So this is the result. That's maybe why the film is a little bit longer, but I think it could be joyful for the audience. Like, our aim is that when you finish to see this movie, you would like to do something. Actually, it's like an activation movie for some kind of imagination that everybody has and maybe didn't use. So that's the result.
Okay, thank you very much. Let's please play the trailer.
Ten moment toho dotyku prostě u té virtuální reality prostě mě chybí. To je jako kdyby člověku prostě chyběl jeden smysl. A i když film je svrchovaně audiovizuální jako médium, tak přesto je schopen právě pomocí zraku zprostředkovávat ty taktilní pocity.
How big is keep it.
Yeah. Yes,
that's all. Hang it, and then we will arrange the small pieces. Okay. Fine.
Ty doteky těch lidí na ty věci zanechávají určitý otisky těch emocí, za kterých se jich dotýkali. A to se dá při určitý jako optimální situaci a citlivý animaci prostě z těch věcí dostat ven. A proto mě třeba vadí ta virtuální, ta počítačová animace, protože tam vlastně chybí ten kontakt, jo, ten kontakt s tou věcí, to děláš, mačkáš nějaký tlačítka a tu realitu, vlastně ta je nedotýkaná, ta realita, tím pádem nemá tenhle rozměr, který můžou mít staré věci, čili není to nějaký staromilství, že jako starožitné věci, no, to ani nemusí být starožitné, čili tam jsou úplně hmatatelné ty doteky těch lidí. Jo.
Žádná instrukce není, jenom buďte. Koukejte se přímo do objektu.
To já právě říkám, že ta animace je od slova animismus, ne prostě animovat, ale animismus. To je to oživování, že?
A teď jak jste udělal tohleto gesto tím prstem v tom uchu, tak to bylo jako docela takový vtipný. Můžu si to natočit?
No. Já už to neudělám tak vtipně.
Můžete? Jestli mi ještě tady chvilku takhle vydržíte a já se na vás budu chvilku koukat.
To je oživování neživý hmoty, to je princip magie, že jo. Takže i když to k tomu používáš techniku, tak furt ten princip zůstává. Je to prostě ten homunculus tam prostě je, že jo.
Vidíš tu srst? Ha?
Nádhera.
Ha?
Já jsem točil tehdy, když mi vzali námět. A když mi ho nevzali, no tak nebylo nikde jít jinam. Jako. Teď by mohl jít člověk jako jinam. To vlastně bylo všecko státní film, tak když ti to je ta dramaturgie odmítla, no tak se nedalo jít do jiného studia. Jako. No a tím pádem prostě to šlo do šuplíku a takhle se to tam nahromadilo. No. A tak to, a má to tu výhodu, že na starý kolena potom máš kam šáhnout, nemusíš už se namáhat, nic vymýšlet. Jenom šáhneš a vytáhneš.
Let's move on to the next film. This film is not only in the Czech Joy competition, but it is also in the international competition in Opus Bonum. The title of the film is White on White by the director Viera Čákanyová. You might remember her previous film Frem, which was premiered last year at Ji.hlava, but also at Berlinale Forum. So I'd like to ask the director Viera Čákanyová to tell us more about her new film.
Hi everyone. As Diana already said, my previous film Frem was premiered in world premiere a year ago in Ji.hlava, and this other film, which is called White on White, was actually shot during the filming of the film Frem, which took place in Antarctica, and the main character was some sort of inhuman entity observing the natural landscape, some artificial intelligence, and we were a crew of three people staying at the Polish Antarctic base, shooting this experimental sci-fi film in very rough conditions. And the whole time I was trying to imagine the inside of an artificial brain, and I put a lot of effort to create my character. But at the same time, in that situation, I was a human being at this very specific exotic place, and struggling with my own body and mind, and it was a very intense experience for me to be part of that landscape and of that weather, and especially when I realized that the landscape I saw and experienced very physically was about to vanish because of climate change, and I witnessed the process going on. And so from some like internal need, I started to make a video diary. And at the beginning, I reflected upon my topic of artificial intelligence, and I tried to realize several talks with an artificial neural network on the internet, but it felt more and more absurd because other very human topics spontaneously emerged, and I was confronted and at times overwhelmed in my human thoughts and emotions. And I found myself in a situation of some kind of a temporary fragile observer, a piece of matter with consciousness that was able to articulate its experience, and so I did. And at some point I realized I was making this other film from my human perspective, and I was the main character in it. And the result is something in between a diary and essay, a dialogue, literally and metaphorically between two perspectives, human and inhuman, and between some artistic and scientific intuition using specific languages to describe the physical reality. It is a Slovak film with a Czech co-production, and now it will be shown on Ji.hlava in a world premiere. And it was like really finished just now, like a few days ago. So it will only start some festival journey after Ji.hlava, I hope, if the situation will be like it made it possible. So.
Okay, thank you. Shall we play the teaser?
Yeah, that's all I want to say.
Okay, thank you very much, Viera.
Čaute, skúj. Skúva jedna, skúva dva. Tam je ešte tretia skúva. To sa ukázalo byť ako kus špinavej skaly. Ladu skôr. To je proste lad. Všade okolo. Táto krajina je droga. Čistá. Koncentrovaná, monochromatická droga. Už som závislá prechádzať s kamerou v akomkoľvek počasí. Moje telo je ako pes, ktorý potrebuje každý deň vyvenčiť. Tak ho venčím. Niekedy ani nevidím, čo točím, pretože displej je čierny kvôli intenzívnemu odrazenému svetlu. Čím lebo je to nejaký program dňa, spôsob, akým urýchľujem disipáciu slnečnej energie.
So now let's move on to another another film, which is actually premiered not in the, only in the Czech Joy, but also in the Opus Bonum International competition. I'd like to invite this film is called Once Upon a Time in Poland, and was directed by Vít Klusák and Filip Remunda. Filip Remunda can present this film together with the producer Alžběta Šelclová.
So we are here to present our movie Once Upon a Time in Poland, which is a documentary film by Vít Klusák and Filip Remunda, which tells a story of a documentary crew that goes to Poland in order to find God. This was the original idea. We thought we will film the movie within 1 year, but after 2 years, we found out that the political situation in Poland changed, and our movie turned from God to as well civil rights and democracy, and how Catholic Church is overpowering people and limiting, let's say, their rights and their thinking and their freedom of speech. And in order to explain the dramaturgy and artistic point of view, I will give the word to Filip.
Thank you. Formally, the film is shot in a form of making of, and you can observe Czech documentary filmmakers how they are traveling from point to point in Poland to cover at the beginning God or religion, and later on political circumstances which are hot point in today's Poland. And imagine that in 21st century Poland, there are still not really visible division between church and state, as it is, for example, in other European countries. But the church is very much interfering into the current political questions, such as interruptions or limiting the freedom or limiting the rights of women. Just to speak about few elements. Imagine that in 21st century, there is an institution called exorcism, and there is several exorcists, and with one of them we filmed a very interesting situation, and we understood that actually exorcism caused a lot of problem of young people who are threatened by exorcists, and it was a very unusual experience for us filmmakers from the Czech Republic. And as Alžběta explained, that the focus of the film during the years of shooting turned from religion to political circumstances. That was caused by the fact that one of the political parties in Poland took the power in Poland, being elected, but slightly more than 50% of population. And actually, this is also what is our film about divided society, because 50% of people disagree with the current happenings, and they are quite suffering from the current political situation, and other 50% is voting for these extremist political parties and supports all that. What I remember what's happened after the premiere in Warsaw, this September was meeting with our sound engineer, who told me that he considered that the film is not relevant for Poland or for Czech Republic specifically, but for the rest of the world, because he sees these tendencies about divided societies all around the globe, from Trump's America to Erdogan, Turkey, or for situation in Hungary. So he would like to see the film as a warning to other nations and societies, don't go in the same steps as we are going in Poland, and protect your freedom. It was very impressive what he told me. And film is now finished. It's going to be screened in Ihlava, and we are looking for other festivals and partners who would screen the film in theaters or online. Thank you very much.
Więc pozdrawiamy tutaj z Poznania, z uroczystości chrztu jubileuszowych. Bardzo się cieszymy, że jesteście z nami, modlicie się z nami, cieszycie się z nami.
My się nie modlimy z wami.
Nie modlicie się?
Nie.
Czemu się nie modlicie?
A czemu przyjechaliście? Zaspokoić co swoją ciekawość?
My przyjechali proto, to jest dłużytá otázka. Že my Češi jsme silně ateistický národ.
My Češi jesteśmy naprawdę mocně ateističní.
Máme s vámi dlouhou hranici.
Máme s panstvem takovou dlouhou hranici.
Naše národy žijou vedle sebe a představují dva opačné extrémy. A to křesťanství jsem přinesl Vojtěch
Ano.
No že... tak, Vojtěch nám přinesl křesťanstvo, zkazí
tak.
Se.
No i Vojtěch byl Čechem.
No tak, vy byliště pěrší.
Ale vlastně od nás, no, od nás. A my už to nemáme teďka.
Dva od nás máme.
Českou křesťanství. No, Karel, a ty jesteš věřící ochřtaný? Ani jesteš.
Ne.
A tvoji rodiče nikdy
nedošli? Nejsou, nejsou.
Nie spotkáváš Jezusa.
Nie spotkáváš Jezusa. Powiedz, Jezus, jesteś panem mojego życia. Jezus.
Jako, że to,
powiedz.
Że mam to říct.
Tak, jesteś panem mojego życia.
Proszę, jak to było?
Jesteś panem mojego życia.
Dobrze, řeknu to, jeśli chcete. Jezus jest panem mojego života.
Właśnie. Jeżeli to powiesz ustami i sercem uwierzysz, tak będzie.
Przepraszam.
No dobry. Že se potřebuje mluvit s panem, jak se jmenuje?
S křesťanem Slonkou.
Ne, má chyba kdy. Zaraz je správce.
A kdy může být?
Nevím.
Že se podívá a přijde?
Jo.
Přesrané.
A co bys mu teda řekl, kdyby se nám to podařilo, Petře?
Nemá, paní mluví. Není.
A kdy bude?
A kdy bude?
Kdy bude doma? Proszę.
Od... Pytaj go, co się pojawiło, co on zrobił.
Szczęść Boże, nie wiecie, księża, kiedy można zastać księdza Słomkę?
Nie. Wita?
Nie wiecie?
My na policję zadzwonimy, że tu się kręcicie, dobrze?
Dobrze.
Proszę bardzo.
Ale nie wiem, w jakiej sprawie w ogóle.
No, że zachodzicie nas tutaj.
Ale w jaki sposób? Zapytaliśmy się tylko o panu.
No to jsme se zrovna neptali na policji, pytaliśmy się na pana Słomka.
Pytaliśmy się o księdza Słomkę.
To nie można zapytać?
Nie, proszę państwa, my się nie umawialiśmy na żaden wywiad.
Tady Petr byl přímo zneužívaný vaším knězem, kterýho tady, který tady bydlí, tak proto tady jsme a proto tady natáčíme. A proto jsme sem vešli bez dovolení.
Piotr, który tu stoi, był bezpośrednio był molestowany przez księdza, który tu mieszka, dlatego tutaj jesteśmy i dlatego tu filmujemy bez żadnego pozwolenia.
No nie, no trzeba było powiedzieć wcześniej, to nie jest eleganckie.
Tyhle, no a to, že ono sexuálně zneužívá slušný je, ten kluk je přímo oběť toho zneužívání.
No, to není OK.
My scháníme pana Slomka.
My šukáme pana Slomka.
To není v pořádku, no.
To není v pořádku.
Co když ho zapírají, co když je vevnitř, skutečnosti?
Co jestli go po prostu tam, že jestli napravdě je, tak napravdě je v środku, že go po prostu ostrzegają i...
Kościół kryje pedofilów, to jest jedyna odpowiedź. Nawet tak, żeby ich nie spotkać. W tak prozaicznej sytuacji. I straszy oczywiście, a straszenie policją, tak?
Znacie taką książeczkę? Brońmy dzieci i młodzież przed demoralizacją. Spis treści o ideologiach, które szkodzą dzieciom. Postmodernizm, ideologia gender, materializm i konsumpcjonizm, czyli zabawki, które szkodzą dzieciom. Znane bardzo Hello Kitty.
No my tutaj kiedyś mieliśmy z nim plecak, ale jak się dowiedzieliśmy o tym, że to usunęliśmy to, wyrzuciliśmy wszystko.
Tak. Była taka akcja oczyszczania domu ze wszystkiego, co by się Bogu nie podobało.
Od czego się z tego właśnie oczyścili?
Był problem z Hello Kitty, bo to taka moda kluszaki. Była, bluzeczki z Hello Kitty, misiaczki, gadżety. Tu na dole zacznij od...
Kotka z piekła. Na oficjalnej stronie Hello Kitty widnieje znamienna data narodzin postaci. 1 listopada, czas Halloween, święto upadłych duchów. Niektóre źródła podają, że postać Hello Kitty stworzono jako dziękczynienie demonom za rzekomą pomoc w uzdrowieniu z raka jamy ustnej 14-letniej dziewczyny.
To jest sprawa demoniczna, no. Widać.
I'm very happy to present our next guests, filmmakers of the film Traces of a Landscape. I'd like to invite the director, Petr Záruba, and his producer, Alice Taberejová, to talk more about this film, about the artist Jan Jedlička.
So our film Traces of a Landscape is a documentary portrait of a Czech painter Jan Jedlička, who emigrated in 69, shortly after Soviet occupation, from Czechoslovakia to Switzerland, where he lived till now. And when he emigrated, he lost not only his home country, but he lost also his artistic language. So in Switzerland, he started to look for new language, how to express himself and his art. And after 10 years of searching, he found the very specific landscape of Italian Maremma in Tuscany. And he fell in love with this landscape. And for more than 40 years, he goes there and he tries to express this very specific landscape by different artistic meanings, like paintings, photographs, and or experimental films. And in our film, we try to find the same approach, how to present his work in this very specific landscape. And let's say something more to our producer.
Yeah, Jedlička uses different techniques, and we would like with the video that will follow present you the technique which we were the most fascinated by, at least me and Peter, which is that he collects colorful rocks and clots and he crushes them, dries them, and then transforms them into pigments that he uses then for his paintings. And he has a palette of more than 250 colors from the Maremma region. Some of them you will see in the video. We premiered our film this spring in Vision du Réel Film Festival, and now we are really happy to have our Czech premiere at Ji.hlava. And of course, sad that we can't meet people during a normal screening. But we would like to virtually invite you with our film to relax, to meditate, to learn how to watch and see things that are not visible at the first sight. We offer you a quiet stay in this beautiful landscape of Tuscany and a look into a creative process of this amazing artist. And we hope you can get inspired by Jedlička as we did with Petr while making this film. And we invite you also to see some of his experimental films that are part of this Ji.hlava Film Festival in a section dedicated to his work. Thank you and enjoy the video and the film.
Prostě ta půda tam, co jsem našel, tak mě ukázala mi, že to stačí na to, na představení toho tématu, té krajiny. Když se na to člověk podívá, tak už vlastně cítí tu realitu. A může s tím dělat svoje abstraktně, to je fuk. S každým kýblem umělý hmoty prostě tohle to ztrácím. já to beru, tak jako tyhle ty věci, tak víceméně, že to je jako jaký druh mandaly. Když to jednou spadne do vody, tak se to tam krásně rozpustí a odplavou ty formy jako rybičky. Já si myslím, že zvědavost je vůbec to nejdůležitější u toho, aby člověk si udržel to napětí a ten zájem. Jiné nehledám žádný konec nebo žádné jako vyústění. Jo? Hledám jenom to neustálé pokračování.
Let's move on to the next film, Miri, Fajta. The directors Petr Kačírek and Martin Chlup already cooperated previously on a short film called Sun. And these two directors, together with their producer Jan Hubáček, will tell us more now about this premiere.
So hello, everybody. We're happy to be able to introduce our new film, Miri, Fajta. It is a feature-length documentary. We have been able to finish it just a few weeks ago. And it actually takes place in the Bronx of Brno. It's a sort of no-go zone, as the local newspaper call it. And we are observing this area for a couple of years already. So I'll let the directors, Petr Kačírek and Martin Chlup, to introduce a bit more about the story and the characters.
Hello. I would like to tell you a few words about our main character, Robin Stria. As our friend Robin came to us 5 years ago with an idea to create first Roma sitcom in Czech Republic. He has actually two aims. First was to create original Roma film culture, because we don't have Roma film culture in Czech Republic, and he is first a Roma filmmaker. And second aim was to introduce new Roma artist generation to whom ordinary Roma people can be proud of. So we talk a lot with Robin about topic of the sitcom, and finally he decided to choose topic of unusually Roma family and her life. And this also is origin of the name of for sitcom and also our documentary, because Miri Fajta means in Roma language my family. Yeah. And after that, Robin decided to first to make a theater version and afterwards a film version. And yeah, it was not easy journey. There are many obstacles and struggles, but finally he did it, and he started to offer his sitcom to internet televisions.
So, against the background of Robin's painful efforts to create original Romani theater and film work, we also try to examine what it actually means to be Romani in Czech Republic today. And its specific forms are reflected in this personal portrait of not only Robin, but also other members of his team. So main topic for us is looking for identity. Roma identity in Czech Republic today, but also for personal and family identity. Because Robin and other members of the team Miri Fajta are adopted.
Mm-hmm. We are happy that Ji.hlava Film Festival has chosen our film for to be in the Czech Joy competition. It's an international premiere for the film, and it will go into distribution in 2021. And so far, we are looking for more festivals who would be able to screen our film, and international distributors and sales agents. So we're looking forward for our audience. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Let's put some material.
Teď, co vám řeknu, tak pro vás může být, máte dvě možnosti, jak to přijmout, to, co vám řeknu.
A to co? Co tam přišel ty?
A je mi strašně těžko to říkat. Nebo pokud já chci nám, Romům, všem, nabídnout ten nejlepší sitcom, který tady v Česku je, tak musím najít ty nejlepší lidi z celého Česka, který to budou dělat. Musím ukončit to, co bylo. A ve chvíli, kdy to ukončím, tak musím udělat konkurs na všechny role, které teď jsou.
Aha.
No, podpásovka, právě to je
to důležitý. Oni to věděli, nebo to ví až dnes tu informaci? To, co říkáš?
Dneska to říkám.
Já jsem o tom slyšela. Aha. Ale věřila jsem tomu, že jako Robin nám všem dáš tu šanci, aby jsme byli lepší.
Však to jo, to máte, tohle je fér. Vy jdete všichni lepší mačky na výběrku, nebo se vytvilo to slovo. Vy máte tu šanci. Já jenom se ptám lidí, kteří nebudou vybráni, co s váma bude, jak se budete cítit.
Nebo lidi, kteří se třeba nepřihlásí, že?
Nechci vás z toho odstřihnout, nikoho. Ani jednoho z vás. A ze všema z vás, kdo jste tady, tak se vám počítám, že máte možnost se na tom podílet a dělat to se mnou. Jestli budete hrát, nebo ne, to je věc druhá.
Ale my všichni chceme hrát.
To cítím tak, že někdo je slabý a ten musí být.
My teďka všichni k tomu máme nějaký vztah, k tomu divadlu. Takhle máme klapky na očích a s těma klapkama na očích se díváme na to, jaký to je.
A to je to
divadlo. Máme ty klapky tak. A já po vás chci, po každém z vás, abyste ty klapky si dali pryč a podívali se takhle s otevřenou hlavou na tu novou šanci, na tu novou výzvu, na tu obrovskou věc, kterou můžeme společně dokázat ve chvíli, kdy obětujete to, co jste do toho dali, pro něco většího, co z toho může být. I za cenu, že v tom nebudu hrát.
Já jenom, že jsi trošku obešel o to, co říkal David. Já ty si říkám, že si myslíš, že to je kvůli tomu, že to potřebuješ pročistit, že jsou tam nějaké slabé články a že to potřebuješ prostě, že to potřebuješ prostě vyčistit a že se to zdá jako
neobčistit. Třeba to tak není.
A nevyjádřím se s tomu, víš?
Ve chvíli, kdy jde o výsledek, což v tuhle chvíli půjde o výsledek, tak ta lidská rovina, nebo lidská ne, vztahová rovina, tak ta vztahová rovina jde bohužel bokem.
Tak co s tou Kristinou, ale co si na ní připravil?
Tak, tak jim nezvím, ale...
A jedeme až po to, než jde Sabina do publika, že?
No, já bych to nedělal až tak dlouhý, protože stejně ten člověk jakoby to prostě vidíme hned, jako jo. Jestli tam dá to, co tam chceme, aby tam bylo, anebo jestli tam nedá, jo.
Tak, zdravím, pojď dál, asi. Tak, si odložíš věci.
To je v pohodě, já jsem to měla nechat tam na sudek,
jo. Jo, já se bojím, že cigáni to podělá.
Tak, já zamřu dveře. Jasný.
A je to.
I would like to invite the director Jindřich Andrš to present his film A New Shift. This film is a world premiere, and it is also the opening film of this festival, as I understood. So it is a very successful start for Jindřich as a film debut. So please, could you tell us more about your film?
Yeah, well, also production-wise, I can just follow that it's a world premiere at Ji.hlava, and next week we have international premiere at DOC Leipzig, Golden Section competition. So to add what you said, Diana. And the film is about a miner, Tomas, who was digging coal his whole life. But then his mine is closed, and he has to decide what to do next. And he decides to try to retrain and to become a computer programmer. And which is very surprising for a lot of people around and also in the Czech Republic and for media. And so he's going to this retraining. And actually it's quite surprising that to learn to program is not such difficult for him. But much more difficult is to be, you know, accepted by the labor market and to succeed as a computer programmer, because, you know, nobody can understand that miner can make such a huge shift in his career. And so we have followed him for 2 years. I think it's quite an intimate story, and Tomas is very, very authentic and also kind of funny character. And after all, he actually makes it, and now he works as a computer programmer. The film is not only kind of celebration of this success story, but we are also asking not only what Tomas got, but this change, but also what he has lost. You know, in next 12 years, 800 million people, manual workers, should lose their jobs because of automatization. So we take this story like a story of many others, and we are questioning like if this is a kind of the solution of this, you know, world situation. And production wise, because I'm sorry, I have my producer Miloš, who is not here today because he's on shooting. But production-wise, I can say that we have this started these festivals, and we are still looking for a sales agent. We can offer a worldwide distribution. So if you are interested, definitely get in touch and we can talk about it. And that's all. Now we will see like a 5-minute clip from the film. Thank you.
Tak můžem?
Hello, už to naběhlo.
Co máš tam šlingu?
Nemáš šlingu, ty pičo.
Hej, to urveš, ty vole, Martin.
Hop!
Jsem to rupo.
Do prdele. Jak to vypadá? Těží ještě nebo kurva už dělají na tom? No, dobré, dobré, díky, čau.
Máte za sebou poslední směnu. Jaké jsou vaše pocity? Jak to vnímáte?
Ne, co mám říct.
A přicházíte na jinou šachtu?
Ne, já končím už.
Ukončíte. A máte nějakou jinou práci už?
Nemám ještě.
Nemáte, bude to teď
hledat. Víte co? Prostě podraz. Podraz, inženýr. Abych měl 34 oddělaný na šachtě a řekli horníkovi, že je zdravý, jako ty roky zdravotního jsem platil na co? Na hovno.
Že vám to řekli, že nemáte nárok.
No, že prej, pokud jsem schopný jednou za měsíc dojít na pracovní úřad, tak nemám nárok, pozbývám nemocenské dávky. Normálně tohle mi řekli.
Takže jste velice jako nešťastný z té situace.
No to víte, že jo, já mám projít tej František, Duklu a tady tuto šachtu. A jako, co jsem udělal? Jenom jsem chtěl uživit svoji rodinu. Každý si myslí, že horník neumí nic, prostě tak jde do této práce, jako, ale ne, já jsem to dělal kvůli tomu, abych uživil rodinu. Já jsem to nedělal proto, abych mohl být sedávat v hospodě. Já neříkám, že bych nebyl.
Zavolejte mi, pane, to nepůjde. Jo, děkuji.
Můžete se prosím spojit na mě? No, víte, já se třepu, bo nejsem na tom nervově dobře. Jako, tohle nepotěší nikoho, jako.
A můžu.
Tak já se zeptám, pro vás dnes byla to poslední šichta?
No, byla to poslední směna, no.
Jaké jako, jsou plány do budoucna?
Tak já osobně bych měl nastoupit na rekvalifikaci Mužsko-Školebanské a tak se uvidí, no, tak si to dám. Tak potom se můj život bude asi ubírat jiným směrem, no.
Říkáte rekvalifikaci, na co byste se rád rekvalifikoval?
Jako přihlásil jsem se tady vlastně před novou šichtu. Jsem se tady přihlásil na rekvalifikační kurz objektově orientované programování.
Takže jsi dolů k počítači.
Tak.
Tomáš, jsem. A kolik máte, prosím vás, roku?
To je 44.
44 a robíte tu jak dlouho?
Tady 21, nebo 21 let.
Takže jdete do nové profese IT. Zkusíte to.
No tak zkusím to. Ale...
Bezvadné, tak jak se daří.
So we're getting to the last third of this presentation. We have three more projects to go. So even though I'm so sure all you selectors have found your favorites, please keep your minds open. We will now present the film Personal Life of a Hole, which is in the world premiere in the Czech Joy competition. The director Ondřej Vavrečka had most of his films in previous editions of this festival. You might remember the last film De Potentia Dei. And so now I would like to ask the director Ondřej Vavrečka and also his producer Alžběta Janáčková to tell us more about their film.
So hello. Hopefully Ondřej is still here. I would like to tell you a little bit more about our film, which was shot on 16 millimeters. We shot it in Czech Republic, in France, in Romania, in Russia. And there are a lot of interesting people. One of them is theologic Annick de Suzanel, or for example, there is nuclear physicist Eva Svetlík. They are talking about different kind of holes, which will Ondřej probably and hopefully tell us about. Anyway, I would like to very thank to Czech Television and Czech Film Fund and also the Promotional Center for Audiovisual Culture Finland, AVEC, who helped us, or SODOC Incubator, and also audiovisual producers of association, because they help us a lot and they believed in us. So thank you. And Ondřej.
Hello everyone, do you hear me?
Yes.
Perfect. During my short presentation, I would ask you for a help because when I started doing this film, I asked myself a question, and now I would like you as well to ask the same question. And the basic question of the film is, what is the world?
Are you waiting for an answer, or is it a rhetoric question?
I'm just waiting for everyone. I'm giving everyone in my short time presentation a time that everyone can ask or respond to this question, what is the world? So everyone can take a time and ask, what is the world? When I was small, I thought the world is something. Now I see that world is nothing. The world is nothing substantial, but it's a hole. Hole, hole, hole. Hole, the hole. Hole, hole. Of the whole, the whole of the whole. So I think, and the film itself shows it, that world is nothing substantial. It doesn't have any strong points, Archimedic points, but it is something which it's with holes, with some kind of void places, which for example is showed in the structure of material, with atomic structure. And so the film itself, its structure and the envoi itself of the film is that without participating of our holes, which are here in our hearts and in our bodies as well, because this body is full of holes as well, we don't see the personal life of the whole, which is ourself and the world itself. So it is, in a way, as I said, a question, the film itself, what is the world? So this is my short presentation.
Okay, thank you very much.
Děura.
Že vlastně luxusem se nestává něco si zapamatovat, ale luxusem se stává něco zapomenout.
A zkrátka...
Těžko se vlastně v tom digitálním světě něco vypouští.
Nemohl byste mi říct, proč vlastně těch šišek je tady tolik?
Čeho?
Proč je těch šišek tolik, se ptá, víš, Vavrečka, proč je tady tolik šišek? Proč jich je vlastně tolik?
Já nemám důvodu. Jako...
Počkej, ale nějaký důvod to přece má?
Tak.
Nějak... Ale dědo, ale oni jsou skvělí, jako my můžeme být rádi, že opravdu oni to jsou krásný šišky, jo? Že z nich nelezou žádný brouci.
Jo. A teď už to nemá smysl. To... Ne. Já prostě chci jít ven a nechci se vracet úplně tohle a chci něco. Co má význam. A přinesu si vždycky tu taštičku takhle a pak se to takhle rozmnoží.
No ale ta taštička má pro vás význam.
No tak pro mě už to význam nemá, jo. Pro mě to mělo ze začátku, poněvadž, já nevím.
To bylo tak,
Musel mě někdo napovídat, že to má význam, ale já už nevím, co to bylo. Ne? Z nějakého průvodu, z nějakého důvodu někdo řekl, nezapomeňte na šišky.
Je parle de l'ontologie de l'homme, c'est-à-dire de ce qu'est l'homme dans son intériorité.
ďoura.
Nous assistons à la création d'Adam. Adam est dit image de Dieu et il est dit aussi mâle et femelle. Ça veut dire aussi que mâle et femelle, sur le plan ontologique, n'est pas du tout l'homme et la femme que nous sommes aujourd'hui.
Now I would kindly ask Ondřej Andrš to actually stay on screen now in the role of a producer of the wonderful project Pripyat Piano, directed by Eliška Cílková. This film is in its Czech premiere at Ji.hlava Film Festival. I believe the world premiere was at Vision Zurel in Lyon. Eliška, maybe you can tell us more.
Hello everyone. So you all probably know that after Chernobyl nuclear disaster, city of Pripyat remained completely deserted. And our first idea was actually to capture all beautiful sounds that remained there. So we started with shooting pianos, because you can imagine that piano is simply too heavy to steal or move. And also it can maintain its sound even if it stays in radioactive place. And during this process, we met Alexei Moskalenko, who was the head of Chernobyl firefighters. And Alexei took us to his Pripyat apartment and he played the piano. And also he told me about a song he composed together with other Chernobyl firefighters to be able to overcome the tragedy. And this was very significant for us. So we decided to meet more former Pripyat inhabitants, and those people told us about their poetry and about their songs and musics they created to be able to deal with Chernobyl disaster. So we decided to shoot with people who visit their apartment sometimes. And we wanted to add this creative process of former inhabitants to tell the whole story.
Yeah, production-wise, we have world premiered at Vision Zurel, and we had like 15 festival selections around the world. We will be in the Zinabi, we were in Taipei, Glasgow Short Festival, we'll go to Festival de Popoli, but now we are going like for a second festival round this year, so we have still like half of the territories free. So if you are interested, we'll be very happy if you could show the film at your festival. Thank you.
Thank you.
Пальцами лучистыми дотронься пыльных клавиш городской души, и она очнется, встрепенется, вырвется из призрачной тиши. Запоет, заплачет, смеется многозвучный городской орган. В небесах распахнутых зажжется неизбывной памяти экран. Темные глазницы мертвых зданий вновь людским наполнятся теплом. Город затаит на миг дыхание, когда ты опустишься в свой дом.
hodiny. Включи! Выше! Вы голова! Держи это место! Держи!
Значит, вы выезжаете в Припять? Алло, да, я слышу! Да, со мной в Карце выезжаете. Там дикий четвертый блок горит крыша. Алло, Полесская?
Да.
Вы, значит, выезжаете на атомную станцию, там горит крыша с дикого четвертого блока.
Жоті в часописах цитати, хоч же давно ніхто не вірить їм. Я вірю, будуть янголи літати над молодим Чорнобилем моїм, над молодим Чорнобилем моїм.
Now I would like to invite on the screen the director Martin Pav, who will present his film Wolves at the Borders. It is a Czech premiere. The world premiere of this film was at Vision Zrelý Neon. And you might remember the previous film of this director, the film Kibera, the story of a slum, which was traveled to many international film festivals. So please, Martin, could you tell us more?
Hello. Wolves at the Borders is a film about the ambivalent relation between human and nature. It tells the story of the crisis in the Czech society, which was caused by the return of wolves back to our landscape. And in the film, we observe the conflict. On one side, there are people who are welcoming wolves and see them as a chance to restore our nature. And on the other side, there are those who perceive wolves as a regular threat to our safety and property. In the film, we follow the escalation of the conflict. We start at the local level and see how it becomes politicized and reaches even the government's level. So the film is a social documentary about the divided society, where wolves are used primarily as a metaphor of anything else, of anything new, which comes to us and we are unable to deal with it. It is primarily a film about us, about human, our fear of unknown, and the anger and frustration growing in our society. Production-wise, we can offer the national premiere in all countries except for France, Germany, Serbia, Estonia, and Romania.
Okay, thank you, Martin, very much. Let's watch the material.
Já si tě dám dolů, šup. A dej mi klobouka.
Tak, pojď, pojď, řekneš ahoj. Řekneš ahoj, jo?
Dobrý den.
Dobrý den.
Dobrý den.
Ahoj.
Ahoj. Takže já vám dám občanku. Havrlán, dobrý den.
Jo.
Už to máte spočítaný. Tak mě zavoláte, až to budete mít. Tak mi to řekněte. Ano. Dobrý, jo, děkuju. Mě uteče had. Díky, naschle.
Tak, taťko, gratuluju.
Tak 99 hlasů, no. Děkuju. No. Tak to je pěkné.
Tak to jo, na to, že seš pokolikátý, tak to je první.
Já, tak vy, tak my, aby neumírali ty zvířata.
No.
Vy si myslíte, že to jde za přítomností vlků, já si myslím, že to jde, když tady ty vlci nebudou. Já prostě
ale tak ještě, já si spíš myslím, že jsme to ještě jako neskusili moc. Jako, že
zkusili,
je tady mluvíme o 3-metrových plotech a ještě jsme neskusili ani elektriku.
Ale zkusili to v celé Evropě a dělají to tam 20 let a nefunguje to.
Já bych si vám jako trošku jako vyčetla, co mě na vás jako mrzí, že čerpáte informace z bulvárních médií, jo? To mi prostě nepřijde úplně fér. Zkusme aspoň jako na něčem prostě se domluvit, že něco jsou prostě opravdu nějaký fakta.
Co byste jako navrhovala, jako jak to udělat, aby nebyly ty problémy s těma domácíma zvířatama?
Ale já to opravdu jako nevím. A každý máme prostě jako je hrozně široký spektrum těch názorů a my každý prostě jsme na tom spektru někde jako trošičku jinde, ale to neznamená, že prostě prostě se spolu jako nemůžeme bavit slušně, že musíme prostě zasahovat jako do nějaké osobní roviny, kdy já jsem tady pro pana Ševce nějaká jako... nevím co.
Farmářka Štílová ze Zdoňova, no. Která mě učí chovat ovce, to jako se na mě
ale
nezlepne.
Já vás, ale jak
to je
já
jako
vás
kdybych já se svým záhonkem brambor učil pěstovat brambory Satýmu Keřkov, akciovou společnost, to je úplně to samé. Já mám jenom tisíckrát tolik, nebo 150krát ovcí víc než vy?
Kolik máte ovcí?
30. Nemám ovce, mám 30 kos a... Letos budu dojít 3 krávy a asi 20 koz. Mám sírárnu, zpracovávám prostě jako to, až k tomu konečnému spotřebiteli, což je trošičku něco jiného, než když chováte ovce a pak je pošlete někam kamionem. Když byste ty ovce dojil, měl byste z nich ještě prostě taky jako větší zisk.
My chováme jiný plemeno, tomu jinému můžete rozumět. My jsme zaměřeni na maso, vy jste na mlíko.
Ale já se vůbec netvářím, že tomu jako nějak extra rozumím, jo. A to, že to tak jako média prostě jako podají.
Tam kamionem, že v tom kamionu je netrhá žádný vlk. Mají tam klimatizaci, mají tam napaječky. A určitě nejsou tak vystresovaný, jako když je prožené vlk. To vám můžu garantovat.
So now we have seen all the 9 presentations. I would like mainly to thank to all the filmmakers that have attended this online presentation. I would like to wish you to get back to the cinemas as soon as possible with your new films. I can imagine it is a confusing time mainly for producers right now, but I believe that each film festival will try and look for a way of how to reach out to audiences as possible. And thank you also very much to Ji.hlava International Documentary Film Festival for hosting such a presentation, showing us the vast variety of approaches that we can find in the contemporary Czech film. And I hope I'll see you all very soon somewhere physically at a film festival. So thank you very much.